Ciao Bellas, welcome to Micheline and I's third makeover video. So the first video you saw, she had shaved hair. The second video you saw, she had long hair. And now as your third video, you can see that she's shaved her hair again. So I'm prepping the unit for her. I'm applying her powder and then another layer of holding spray, and I'm doing this twice. I'm doing this because the unit she's using is transparent lace, so I wanted to match the lace perfectly with her skin tone. So you can use a wig cap, but as she has a shaved head, you don't actually need to use a wig cap. So I'm just putting the wig straight on using our adjustable and removable elastic band method with the four clips at the bottom, which clip into the band at the nape area. And this is how the unit arrives. So the hairline and baby hairs are all perfectly set for you. I do all the hard work and perfect everything. So as soon as you receive her, she is ready for instant wear. Now I'm just going to be cutting the lace. You have to cut the lace on your own unit because it's basically like a symbol that the unit is new, and also different people like to cut their lace differently. Most of the time you can just use normal scissors and cut along the hairline. If you were going to be doing something more detailed like a high sleek pony with your unit, you could use jagged scissors also. Now I'm going to be cutting the earpieces off. This is really important if you would like sideburn or ear coverage. When you wear a unit with an elastic band, you will never get sideburn or ear coverage because the way that the elastic band works is it holds the wig intact by pulling each earpiece to the back around your nape. So that's how the wig is secure. So it's fantastic and it has so many benefits, super healthy, super secure for you. It's one of the best methods today, which is why I always go with it. However, you don't get as much sideburn coverage. So if you cut this way and you cut a U-part shape around the ears, you will get coverage. So if you would like to have that, then this is how you do it. You just want to section a U-part around your ears. Make sure you're holding the front of the lace really nice and secure so you know that it's in place. So maybe if you're a beginner, you can hold it for yourself and you can ask a friend or your hubby to cut it on the side. This is how the hairline is looking, and I just am fitting it to make sure that it's sitting right where I like it and also where she feels comfortable. Now I'm just flipping the lace back. This is a great step to do because it will allow you to know exactly where you want to apply your gel. Using baby wipes to clean the area, you can also use 99% alcohol. Using the white got to be glued today. I just prefer the white got to be glued, but it's all up to you. This is a very exciting product that I've been developing. I'm still perfecting it, so it's not available for sale yet, but it is a brush that comes as a baby hair brush and also something you can apply your powder with and also your got to be glued gel with. So I've just applied one thin layer. Now I'm using a cool heat to dry it for about 8 to 10 seconds. Now I'm just gently flipping the lace down, and as you can see, she's perfectly in place. And you want to make sure that you are using a comb or a butter knife or something that isn't your fingers to apply it if you wanted an extra hold. If you're just using the unit for a day with the got to be glued, you can definitely use your fingers. You won't have to worry about it too much. But if you did want to have the hold on for a little bit more, then you should definitely use something not your fingers. So like I said, a comb or a butter knife. Now, the secret is you want to use the end of your rat tail comb and you want to do circles going forward. So you're basically rubbing the hair in front of the lace. And that is the secret to making it super natural without having to do heavy, heavy baby hairs. So I am just going to be reapplying the gel at the bottom and doing the same steps. I'm just using the tip of my acrylic nails and my rat tail comb to set the bottom. And then I'm going to be using a piece of material that I'm going to be wrapping all around the hairline of the unit just to set and make sure it's very secure while it dries perfectly. The minimum time to apply the material around the hairline of your unit is 10 minutes. However, if you wanted the unit to be applied with the gel for like a week or as maximum time as possible, then you could definitely do this at nighttime and you could put the material on so you can sleep with it, so you would get a stronger hold. If you were just going to be using your wig for a day, you don't have to do this step. It's really just if you wanted it over a day.